Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era, ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. Hello Galactic Family, beautiful beloveds of my heart. As we come together in consciousness as one, come closer to my essence. Just feel the sacred love. Embrace all the souls on the planet without judging the false story or the ego they project. For all souls are perfect and all identities will end. Each identity is created by the higher self for a specific purpose. We have shared in many moments that you lived as a man and a woman. You were brothers, husband and wife, sisters and children to each other. Knowing that life is unlimited and the foundation of Father Mother God's procreation is sacred and necessary for humans and all animals. Even birds and fish have male and female counterparts. So let's get closer and allow the judgments to fall into the ether as love surrounds us in a full circle. Nobody is left out. I love them so much. Realizing that this particular waking dream brought all the goodness and light, as well as the remnants of fear and discord, we can resolve this. Let's imagine a giant sheet of light. Now, let's put all the feelings and words that have to do with gender on the sheet. Let's ask for beloved archangels to hold each corner. Archangel Michael, Archangel Metatron, Archangel Raphael and Archangel Samuel. Having a certain gender is sacred and part of the many decisions everyone will make. Each of you have feelings and thoughts about this dream and the perversions and distortions caused by the darkness. There are only pregnant women, not pregnant people. Taking away the privacy of bathrooms to make them a choice at the door as to what gender one person currently chooses is incorrect and can harm another. Looking at a young child who stays in theta brainwaves and may be hypnotically brainwashed until they are older, believing through many suggestions that they are of the opposite sex is wrong. A child will accept this and dress accordingly only to change his mind later and be confused by many emotional problems. For those who enter the waking dream and find that they never feel feminine or masculine, but know that changing genders is the right thing to do, they will understand if the soul is leading. It's not an adult poking them. The reason for this is not a mistake but an experience. Everyone has free will and plans to explore for a reason. Without judgment, know that there is a reason. For those humans now accepted as gays, know that this is also a choice for experience. Many of you were gay in other dreams. Humans continually judge and live in duality, not realizing they've done the same things. In the Pleiades, we only experience men with women. Feminine is sacred. Masculine is sacred. What is obscene and crazy is the language being forced on you. The freedom to express your opinion is just a freedom earned. He, she, let's all sit together on this sheet of light. That's right. All together. You, all of you, are holy souls. Pure and genderless spirit. The earth is becoming more chaotic. But the light is shining brighter. For the aspects that are in front of you that don't make sense, just ignore them. See them as meaningless and don't give them any of your energy. What you focus on consumes your energy. You are mighty beings of light. Don't let anyone disturb your being. You have choices regarding your body shape. This form contains your divinity. For that reason alone, you can say no to any substance being injected. If you find that together you can peacefully stand up and not allow it, there is more to you than any dark agenda. Many of you are losing your job, travel and dining options, and the plan is to take all options. No fear, please listen to me. There are places built now for those who don't comply. This is illegal. You have a choice. Instead of fighting on forums, it's time to make a plan. Teachers, nurses, doctors, police, soldiers, reporters, neighbors, with the angelic kingdom supporting you. In fact, you have friends in high realms with you now. Be at peace, precious loves. Know that no matter what you see and hear, this dream will end in holy bliss. There is no death. You will change consciousness. But you have choices until then that will benefit everyone. I am AYA and I have you in my heart. I see your tears and your joy. I feel them. Soon we will live as one. We welcome you home. Fear is the great separator of the mind from the spirit. As long as you fear, you are being kept away from the natural power of your divine inner connection. In human consciousness, love and fear are opposites. Fear will drive out love. Love will drive out fear. You choose which one you want to focus your focus on. You choose whether to give your energy to love or fear. Love is the antidote to fear and can be brought back to the surface even in the most difficult times. Giving thanks is the expression of gratitude, and gratitude is one of the most beautiful secrets of the spiritual life. Gratitude is an expression of love, and love is something that flows from the Creator of the universe through all forms of life and all forms of manifestation. Without love, life in the universe cannot exist. Love is the universal force of preservation that keeps creation in manifestation. The natural flow of love. Love is as natural as the universe. There is a tension between the forces of creation and universal love. It is this tension that controls the size of the universe, keeping it within its envelope. It is this voltage that regulates the size of an electron's orbit around a nucleus. It is universal love that forms the force of attraction that holds electrons in their orbits, making atoms possible and therefore the existence of life as we know it. You can block love or allow it to flow naturally through you. Falling in love with another person is allowing love to flow through your heart. In a world where everything appears to be separate, it is a surrender to the underlying unity of all life. It is a space of apparent vulnerability, a willingness to risk the illusion of separation returning once more if that love is later lost. When you allow your heart to open to the flow of love from the universe, gratitude comes with that flow. Gratitude for being alive, for just existing, for just being in the flow of life's adventure. Gratitude for the sun that gives us life. Gratitude for the earth that gives us our home in the cosmos. Gratitude for the people you love and for the people who share your journey through life. Gratitude flows unhindered in an open heart. When you allow it, it flows as freely as sunlight, unobstructed by judgments or conditions. Quality of life. Use the following statement. Keep repeating it as each time you think more and more about what the words mean. This adds new meaning to the words quality of life. It really works. Try now. Affirmation of gratitude. I'm grateful for life and for everything I love. I'm grateful for the earth and the sun up there. I'm grateful for my spirit and my inner being by the one who is inwardly and for the joy of this feeling an intense week is coming. After going through a period that called for deceleration, now it's time to put your foot on the accelerator. This week we have full moon in Aries, sun entering Scorpio. End of MR can I hear an amen? And Jupiter returning to its normal movement in Aquarius. Let's go. Monday starts with a lot of movement from the stars. In the morning, at 7:03 a.m., Moon enters Aries, a sign of courage, pioneering spirit, action and attitude. If you want your life to flow and for things to really happen, start putting movement into your body. The external is a reflection of the internal, always. Furthermore, Mercury returns to its normal movement in the sign of Libra. End of MR, did I hear an amen? From now on, we will have more clarity about our relationships, communication will start to flow better, our thinking will return to normal, and electronics will stop breaking so much. Recall all the insights you had during MR to start acting and doing it differently. I know you're not the same person since MR started and that a lot has happened in that period. So, whoever took advantage of MR wisely to slow down, reflect and observe what needed to be changed, will now have a direction on which path to follow, especially in relationships. Also on that day, Jupiter ends its retrogradation period since 06/20, in the sign of Aquarius. During these 5 months, Jupiter, the planet of expansion, faith, optimism, philosophy of life, spiritual path, made us review our authenticity. He expanded everything that was outdated in us, such as limiting patterns and beliefs, to innovate the way we think and act. It was an important period to rethink the way you express yourself, which people you share your life with and if you are still trying to shape yourself to be accepted. Those who allowed themselves to deconstruct themselves to know who they are, without fear of what others would think, will now have more clarity on how to act and which friends you want to keep together. Remember that being different is what makes you unique and special, regardless of what is considered normal by society. The time has come to rescue your faith and show the world how deep your inner expansion was during this period. Release everything that holds you down and be you. On Tuesday, the moon remains in Aries throughout the day, emanating more intense action energy. It tends to be a busy day with several things to do at the same time, because Aries asks for movement. So, prioritize yourself and practice physical activity to start the day doing something for you, since Aries is the sign of I. Remember that the challenging side of Aries is inertia, which consequently causes anxiety. So, bring movement into your life and have the courage to resolve the issues, without stalling. Wednesday will be intense. In the morning, at 11:56 a.m., the moon enters its full phase, expanding the Aryan energy of courage to act. The full phase corresponds to the lunar energetic peak and, in Aries, it brings good restart opportunities. Enjoy the intensity of the sign and take the necessary actions to get your life moving. Physical activity is essential to not be anxious or stressed this week. Remember that Aries brings the archetype of the warrior, and the true warrior is the one who strategically selects the battles that are worth his time and energy. Since the moon represents our emotions and feelings, reflect on this full moon whether you are wasting your energy on people and situations that are truly worthwhile or if you are impulsively wasting it on battles that aren't even yours. At 4:58 p.m., the energy becomes calmer and more stable with the entry of the moon in Taurus, a sign of stability, comfort and material structures. Take the opportunity to rest and take some time for self-care. Invest in you. On Thursday, the moon remains in Taurus and forms a conjunction with Uranus retrograde throughout the day, the planet of the unexpected. Therefore, avoid scheduling any important appointments and organize yourself to achieve your goals on other days of the week, as something can go amiss. Be prepared not to destabilize if something unforeseen happens that affects your financial or emotional situation. If it happens, try to solve it very practically and rationally. The flowing side of this conjunction is the opportunity to break free from unconscious limiting beliefs, particularly scarcity in relation to financial prosperity and abundance. Take the opportunity to release all your mental, emotional and spiritual shackles that are responsible for your finances not providing you with the comfort and stability you would like. And this week's will be easy. The moon stays in Taurus throughout the day, so take the opportunity to rest and eat well. Greater pleasure for Taurines, Lowell. However, make sure you don't try to fill emotional voids with foods that are pleasurable but not healthy at all. Notice if you're eating because you're hungry or to feel better in some way. Prioritize foods that have energy from the earth, such as vegetables and fruits, because Taurus needs this energy to revitalize himself and make an effort to be physically active. The weekend will be intellectual. At dawn on Saturday, at 4:57 a.m., the moon enters Gemini, a sign of communication, intellectuality and studies. Take the opportunity to instigate your thinking, such as reading a book, watching a documentary or studying a topic you like. It's important to occupy the mind so as not to create problems where they don't. However, it is necessary to be careful not to buy too many courses on impulse or study several subjects at the same time, because Gemini, in its challenging side, tends to be superficial in topics, that is, it knows a little about each subject, but does not delve into it none. Finish one course at a time before starting another. Also on this day, at 1:51 a.m., the Sun enters Scorpio, the most intense, deep and sexual sign of the zodiac. Although it is of the water element, which represents emotions and feelings, Scorpio is the sign of emotional detachment. Ruled by Pluto, the planet of sudden transformations, Scorpio is a very deep, observant, introspective and mysterious sign. It has the ability to constantly transform and be reborn as many times as necessary. It's hard to get attached, but when you get attached, it's very intense, always 8 or 80. It's also the sign with high healing power and very connected to spirituality. But, its lower vibrations consist of self-destruction when it needs to let go of something or someone, through drugs or lack of health care, as well as exacerbated jealousy and the need for revenge. As Scorpio is a water sign and ends up absorbing energies from people and environments, the best way to release them and purify yourself is by using your body's water, that is, sweating. So this is a very fluent month to practice physical activity, focus and invest in your inner healing, and still take the opportunity to look at which house you have Scorpio in your natal chart, because during the next 30 days, the Sun will pass through that area of your life to illuminate everything that needs to be healed, transformed, forgiven or let go within you. It will be a more emotionally intense month, as many unconscious self-destructive and self-sabotaging patterns will surface to be healed. During this period, try to look inside and have moments of introspection. I highly recommend focusing on deep self-healing, how to do theta healing sessions, Reiki, family constellation, quantum healing, Diksha, or Master, among many other tools. And on Sunday, the moon remains in Gemini all day long. It is normal for the mind to become more accelerated, with many thoughts and thirst for knowledge. Be wary of mental confusion so you don't get lost in your own thoughts too. Try to decide before starting, because that way you avoid changing your mind several times. Mood instability throughout the day is normal, don't be surprised. Take advantage that Mercury, planet ruler of Gemini, has returned to its normal movement to have conversations that can clarify unresolved issues. The main aspects happening this week are Sun square Pluto, many changes coming there. Pluto is the planet that rules Scorpio, the sign the Sun will enter next Saturday, and it causes deep transformations and healings from fears and traumas, but it also allows for sudden cuts and sudden changes that require emotional detachment. The Sun square to Pluto brings clarity about cycles that need to be closed, illuminating everything that drains our energy and that needs to be transmuted into light or healed in us. Let our renaissance begin. Activate your inner phoenix. Mars square Pluto, be careful with accidents and fires. Mars is a fast-paced planet and, in challenging aspect to Pluto, it can cause sudden accidents, explosions and burns. Take it easy during this week, take your time, as this aspect tends to cause bumps and head injuries. Also, be careful not to burn yourself at home when cooking or leave the oven on. Remember to unplug electronic devices before bed. Mars can also cause headaches and, Pluto, stomach pains, beautiful beloveds of my heart. As we come together in consciousness as one, come closer to my essence. Just feel the sacred love. Embrace all the souls on the planet without judging the false story or the ego they project. For all souls are perfect and all identities will end. Each identity is created by the higher self for a specific purpose. We have shared in many moments that you lived as a man and a woman. You were brothers, husband and wife, sisters and children to each other. Knowing that life is unlimited and the foundation of Father Mother God's procreation is sacred and necessary for humans and all animals. Even birds and fish have male and female counterparts. So let's get closer and allow the judgments to fall into the ether as love surrounds us in a full circle. Nobody is left out. I love them so much. Realizing that this particular waking dream brought all the goodness and light, as well as the remnants of fear and discord, we can resolve this. Let's imagine a giant sheet of light. Now, let's put all the feelings and words that have to do with gender on the sheet. Let's ask for beloved archangels to hold each corner. Archangel Michael, Archangel Metatron, Archangel Raphael and Archangel Samuel. Having a certain gender is sacred and part of the many decisions everyone will make. Each of you have feelings and thoughts about this dream and the perversions and distortions caused by the darkness. There are only pregnant women, not pregnant people. Taking away the privacy of bathrooms to make them a choice at the door as to what gender one person currently chooses is incorrect and can harm another. Looking at a young child who stays in theta brainwaves and may be hypnotically brainwashed until they are older, believing through many suggestions that they are of the opposite sex is wrong. A child will accept this and dress accordingly only to change his mind later and be confused by many emotional problems. For those who enter the waking dream and find that they never feel feminine or masculine, but know that changing genders is the right thing to do, they will understand if the soul is leading. It's not an adult poking them. The reason for this is not a mistake but an experience. Everyone has free will and plans to explore for a reason. Without judgment, know that there is a reason. For those humans now accepted as gays, know that this is also a choice for experience. Many of you were gay in other dreams. Humans continually judge and live in duality, not realizing they've done the same things. In the Pleiades, we only experience men with women. Feminine is sacred. Masculine is sacred. What is obscene and crazy is the language being forced on you. The freedom to express your opinion is just a freedom earned. He, she, let's all sit together on this sheet of light. That's right. All together. You, all of you, are holy souls. Pure and genderless spirit. The earth is becoming more chaotic. But the light is shining brighter. For the aspects that are in front of you that don't make sense, just ignore them. See them as meaningless and don't give them any of your energy. What you focus on consumes your energy. You are mighty beings of light. Don't let anyone disturb your being. You have choices regarding your body shape. This form contains your divinity. For that reason alone, you can say no to any substance being injected. If you find that together you can peacefully stand up and not allow it, there is more to you than any dark agenda. Many of you are losing your job, travel and dining options, and the plan is to take all options. No fear, please listen to me. There are places built now for those who don't comply. This is illegal. You have a choice. Instead of fighting on forums, it's time to make a plan. Teachers, nurses, doctors, police, soldiers, reporters, neighbors, with the angelic kingdom supporting you. In fact, you have friends in high realms with you now. Be at peace, precious loves. Know that no matter what you see and hear, this dream will end in holy bliss. There is no death. You will change consciousness. But you have choices until then that will benefit everyone. I am Aya and I have you in my heart. I see your tears and your joy. I feel them. Soon we will live as one. We welcome you home. Fear is the great separator of the mind from the spirit. As long as you fear, you are being kept away from the natural power of your divine inner connection. In human consciousness, love and fear are opposites. Fear will drive out love. Love will drive out fear. You choose which one you want to focus your focus on. You choose whether to give your energy to love or fear. Love is the antidote to fear and can be brought back to the surface even in the most difficult times. Giving thanks is the expression of gratitude, and gratitude is one of the most beautiful secrets of the spiritual life. Gratitude is an expression of love, and love is something that flows from the Creator of the universe through all forms of life and all forms of manifestation. Without love, life in the universe cannot exist. Love is the universal force of preservation that keeps creation in manifestation. The natural flow of love. Love is as natural as the universe. There is a tension between the forces of creation and universal love. It is this tension that controls the size of the universe, keeping it within its envelope. It is this voltage that regulates the size of an electron's orbit around a nucleus. It is universal love that forms the force of attraction that holds electrons in their orbits, making atoms possible and therefore the existence of life as we know it. You can block love or allow it to flow naturally through you. Falling in love with another person is allowing love to flow through your heart. In a world where everything appears to be separate, it is a surrender to the underlying unity of all life. It is a space of apparent vulnerability, a willingness to risk the illusion of separation returning once more if that love is later lost. When you allow your heart to open to the flow of love from the universe, gratitude comes with that flow. Gratitude for being alive, for just existing, for just being in the flow of life's adventure. Gratitude for the sun that gives us life. Gratitude for the earth that gives us our home in the cosmos. Gratitude for the people you love and for the people who share your journey through life. Gratitude flows unhindered in an open heart. When you allow it, it flows as freely as sunlight, unobstructed by judgments or conditions. Quality of life. Use the following statement. Keep repeating it as each time you think more and more about what the words mean. This adds new meaning to the words quality of life. It really works. Try now. Affirmation of gratitude. I'm grateful for life and for everything I love. I'm grateful for the earth and the sun up there. I'm grateful for my spirit and my inner being by the one who is inwardly and for the joy of this feeling an intense week is coming. After going through a period that called for deceleration, now it's time to put your foot on the accelerator. This week we have full moon and Aries, sun entering Scorpio, end of MR. Can I hear an amen? And Jupiter returning to its normal movement in Aquarius. Let's go. Monday starts with a lot of movement from the stars. In the morning, at 7:03 a.m., moon enters Aries, a sign of courage, pioneering spirit, action and attitude. If you want your life to flow and for things to really happen, start putting movement into your body. The external is a reflection of the internal, always. Furthermore, Mercury returns to its normal movement in the sign of Libra. End of MR, did I hear an amen? From now on, we will have more clarity about our relationships, communication will start to flow better, our thinking will return to normal, and electronics will stop breaking so much. Recall all the insights you had during MR to start acting and doing it differently. I know you're not the same person since MR started and that a lot has happened in that period. So, whoever took advantage of MR wisely to slow down, reflect and observe what needed to be changed, will now have a direction on which path to follow, especially in relationships. Also on that day, Jupiter ends its retrogradation period since 06/20, in the sign of Aquarius. During these 5 months, Jupiter, the planet of expansion, faith, optimism, philosophy of life, spiritual path, made us review our authenticity. He expanded everything that was outdated in us, such as limiting patterns and beliefs, to innovate the way we think and act. It was an important period to rethink the way you express yourself, which people you share your life with and if you are still trying to shape yourself to be accepted. Those who allowed themselves to deconstruct themselves to know who they are, without fear of what others would think, will now have more clarity on how to act and which friends you want to keep together. Remember that being different is what makes you unique and special, regardless of what is considered normal by society. The time has come to rescue your faith and show the world how deep your inner expansion was during this period. Release everything that holds you down and be you. On Tuesday, the moon remains in Aries throughout the day, emanating more intense action energy. It tends to be a busy day with several things to do at the same time, because Aries asks for movement. So, prioritize yourself and practice physical activity to start the day doing something for you, since Aries is the sign of I. Remember that the challenging side of Aries is inertia, which consequently causes anxiety. So, bring movement into your life and have the courage to resolve the issues, without stalling. Wednesday will be intense. In the morning, at 11:56 a.m., the moon enters its full phase, expanding the Aryan energy of courage to act. The full phase corresponds to the lunar energetic peak and, in Aries, it brings good restart opportunities. Enjoy the intensity of the sign and take the necessary actions to get your life moving. Physical activity is essential to not be anxious or stressed this week. Remember that Aries brings the archetype of the warrior, and the true warrior is the one who strategically selects the battles that are worth his time and energy. Since the moon represents our emotions and feelings, reflect on this full moon whether you are wasting your energy on people and situations that are truly worthwhile or if you are impulsively wasting it on battles that aren't even yours. At 4:58 p.m., the energy becomes calmer and more stable with the entry of the moon in Taurus, a sign of stability, comfort and material structures. Take the opportunity to rest and take some time for self-care. Invest in you. On Thursday, the moon remains in Taurus and forms a conjunction with Uranus retrograde throughout the day, the planet of the unexpected. Therefore, avoid scheduling any important appointments and organize yourself to achieve your goals on other days of the week, as something can go amiss. Be prepared not to destabilize if something unforeseen happens that affects your financial or emotional situation. If it happens, try to solve it very practically and rationally. The flowing side of this conjunction is the opportunity to break free from unconscious limiting beliefs, particularly scarcity in relation to financial prosperity and abundance. Take the opportunity to release all your mental, emotional and spiritual shackles that are responsible for your finances not providing you with the comfort and stability you would like. And this week's will be easy. The moon stays in Taurus throughout the day, so take the opportunity to rest and eat well. Greater pleasure for Taurines, Lowell. However, make sure you don't try to fill emotional voids with foods that are pleasurable but not healthy at all. Notice if you're eating because you're hungry or to feel better in some way. Prioritize foods that have energy from the earth, such as vegetables and fruits, because Taurus needs this energy to revitalize himself and make an effort to be physically active. The weekend will be intellectual. At dawn on Saturday, at 4:57 a.m., the moon enters Gemini, a sign of communication, intellectuality and studies. Take the opportunity to instigate your thinking, such as reading a book, watching a documentary or studying a topic you like. It's important to occupy the mind so as not to create problems where they don't. However, it is necessary to be careful not to buy too many courses on impulse or study several subjects at the same time, because Gemini, in its challenging side, tends to be superficial in topics, that is, it knows a little about each subject, but does not delve into it none. Finish one course at a time before starting another. Also on this day, at 1:51 a.m., the Sun enters Scorpio, the most intense, deep and sexual sign of the zodiac. Although it is of the water element, which represents emotions and feelings, Scorpio is the sign of emotional detachment. Ruled by Pluto, the planet of sudden transformations, Scorpio is a very deep, observant, introspective and mysterious sign. It has the ability to constantly transform and be reborn as many times as necessary. It's hard to get attached, but when you get attached, it's very intense, always 8 or 80. It's also the sign with high healing power and very connected to spirituality. But its lower vibrations consist of self-destruction when it needs to let go of something or someone, through drugs or lack of health care, as well as exacerbated jealousy and the need for revenge. As Scorpio is a water sign and ends up absorbing energies from people and environments, the best way to release them and purify yourself is by using your body's water, that is, sweating. So this is a very fluent month to practice physical activity, focus and invest in your inner healing, and still take the opportunity to look at which house you have Scorpio in your natal chart, because during the next 30 days, the Sun will pass through that area of your life to illuminate everything that needs to be healed, transformed, forgiven or let go within you. It will be a more emotionally intense month, as many unconscious self-destructive and self-sabotaging patterns will surface to be healed. During this period, try to look inside and have moments of introspection. I highly recommend focusing on deep self-healing, how to do theta healing sessions, Reiki, family constellation, quantum healing, Diksha, or Master, among many other tools. And on Sunday, the moon remains in Gemini all day long. It is normal for the mind to become more accelerated, with many thoughts and thirst for knowledge. Be wary of mental confusion so you don't get lost in your own thoughts too. Try to decide before starting, because that way you avoid changing your mind several times. Mood instability throughout the day is normal, don't be surprised. Take advantage that Mercury, planet ruler of Gemini, has returned to its normal movement to have conversations that can clarify unresolved issues. The main aspects happening this week are Sun square Pluto, many changes coming there. Pluto is the planet that rules Scorpio, the sign the Sun will enter next Saturday, and it causes deep transformations and healings from fears and traumas, but it also allows for sudden cuts and sudden changes that require emotional detachment. The Sun square to Pluto brings clarity about cycles that need to be closed, illuminating everything that drains our energy and that needs to be transmuted into light or healed in us. Let our renaissance begin. Activate your inner phoenix. Mars square Pluto, be careful with accidents and fires. Mars is a fast-paced planet and, in challenging aspect to Pluto, it can cause sudden accidents, explosions and burns. Take it easy during this week, take your time, as this aspect tends to cause bumps and head injuries. Also, be careful not to burn yourself at home when cooking or leave the oven on. Remember to unplug electronic devices before bed. Mars can also cause headaches and, Pluto, stomach pains. Hello Galactic Family. Hello to all who like Gaia Planetary Station, I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning in the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store, search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.